Welcome to the TI Precision Lab series on light sensors. My name is Alex Bendar-Young, and I am an applications engineer at Texas Instruments. As we have discussed in past videos, light sensors are most often put behind some sort of cover material. In this video, we will discuss the effect cover materials have on light sensors and how to select one for your application. Cover materials most often take the form of a transparent or translucent piece of glass or plastic placed over the sensor, as shown. Ideally, a cover material would not change the brightness or spectrum of the ambient light. However, even some seemingly clear materials, like glass, can affect the light passing through. For example, consider the spectral response plot shown for a 10 mm thick piece of glass. The light level is attenuated, on average, by 15%. The response is also not perfectly flat in the visible spectrum. It has a small peak at around 475 nanometers. While this effect is small for a thin piece of glass, a very thick piece of glass can severely distort the spectrum, which can even be noticed by the naked eye as a teal-tinted color. Manufacturers often put light sensors behind a cover material with a dark ink printed on it. These dark inks intentionally attenuate the light passing through to hide the sensor and other electronics from the user for a cleaner look. This is most often seen in display applications where the screen bezel is black with a hole for the sensor. These dark inks usually have a much greater effect on the light than the cover material itself. One of these effects is light attenuation. Dark inks used on cover materials typically pass 2 to 20% of the light incident. While this may improve the aesthetics, it will reduce the amount of light hitting the sensor, and therefore also reduce low light sensitivity of the sensor. For example, if the ink transmits 2% of ambient light at 50 lux, the sensor will only see 1 lux. Using the equation shown, the sensor resolution and glass transmission can be used to calculate the resolution of the sensor in the system. For a sensor with a 100 millilux resolution and a 2% transmissive glass, the system will have a resolution of 5 lux. This value should be compared with the minimum resolution needed by the application. To improve the resolution of the system, either a more transmissive glass or a sensor with a better resolution, such as TI's OPT-4001 light sensor, can be selected. This effect applies across the whole range of the light sensor. If the light sensor has a full-scale reading of 10 kLux with a 2% glass, the system will have a max lux of 500 kLux. Therefore, the range of lux values detectable by the system is 5 to 500 kLux with the 2% glass we have chosen. Dark inks and dyes have been used for a long time in infrared transmitting and sensing applications, such as those used in IR remote controls. Many dark inks on the market absorb visible light at a much greater ratio than IR light. This ratio can be as high as 50 times for inks made specifically for these IR applications to 2 to 3 times for inks made specifically for visible light sensors. A relative increase in the IR content will cause increased lux errors in the light sensor. This will vary based on the light source type. Additionally, some applications, such as cameras with near IR LEDs for night vision, use strong IR emitters that introduce additional IR content. For best performance, ambient light sensor specific ink should be used, as well as a sensor with high IR rejection. Dark inks also modify the visible spectrum of light and typically attenuate blue and green light more than red light. Even in an ink made for light sensors, this can be as much as 10 times more red light. This is similar to looking through a red piece of tinted glass, as shown. As we have mentioned in past videos, light sensors need to match the human eye photopic spectral response to get accurate lux readings. Sensors achieve this by integrated filters on the sensor that create the desired profile. If a cover material changes the spectral content of the ambient light, it will cause the sensor response to shift away from the photopic response and to read incorrectly. With a typical white light source, this effect may not cause large errors in Lux, since red is weighted low in the photopic response. However, this error will vary from light source to light source and cannot be easily calibrated out. Therefore, it is desirable to get a cover material with the flattest response in the visible spectrum. Up until now, we have discussed the average effect of a cover material on a light sensor, but these effects will vary from lot to lot and sample to sample by some amount. This can be caused by a number of factors, such as changes in material thickness, variation in the processes like applying the dark ink, as well as mechanical alignment of the cover material to the sensor and other system-level variations. Most of these variations will only affect the amount of light attenuated in the cover material, but may vary significantly. Larger variations in attenuation may require that each unit is calibrated to ensure Lux accuracy. To summarize, cover materials can cause several issues leading to Lux inaccuracies on the light sensor. They can attenuate the light hitting the sensor, leading to a less sensitive sensor. They can shift the spectrum of the ambient light and IR, leading to a Lux error that will vary with the ambient light spectrum. Finally, the cover material can vary from unit to unit with a different mix of the above issues. So what can we do about this? The issues discussed can either result in ambient light attenuation or ambient light spectral shift. To account for attenuation from a cover material, we can multiply the raw data by an attenuation factor. The process to measure this factor will be discussed in more detail in the next chapter of this video series. It is also important to consider that independent of calibration, the low light sensitivity of the sensor decreases in proportion with the cover material attenuation, as mentioned earlier. Additionally, spectral shift from cover materials cannot be easily calibrated out in a light sensor, and will cause a Lux error that varies with the light spectrum. As an example, if the calibration uses a white LED, it would not account for any IR sensitivity since LEDs produce almost no IR light. This calibration would cause a sensor with IR sensitivity to read too high in sunlight, since sunlight does have a significant amount of IR light. For these reasons, it is important to consider the cover material response and transmission in the visible region, as well as the ratio of visible to IR transmission. IR Lux errors can also be reduced by using a sensor with high IR rejection ratio, such as OPT-3004. In summary, with careful consideration of the sensor, cover material, and calibration, as well as the application requirements, accurate readings can be achieved. Dark inks made for visible light sensing give best performance. In applications requiring low light sensitivity, the system resolution equation can be used to select the needed sensor resolution and cover material transmissivity based on application requirements. Calibration may be required for the system depending on the attenuation and variation seen. Finally, choosing a sensor with high IR rejection and a photopic response will greatly improve performance. To find more light sensor technical resources and to search TI products, please visit the link shown. Thanks for taking the time to watch this video. Please try the following quiz. With a 5 millilux to 50K lux sensor range and a cover material that transmits 5% of ambient light, what is the range of the integrated system? The correct answer is B. Using the equation for system resolution, this can be calculated. The range values vary in inverse proportion to the percent transmittance.